Well, g'day everyone. I'm joined today by Pat Turner. It's wonderful to be here with you, Pat. I want to thank you as the head of the Coalition of Peaks, bringing together over 50 wonderful organisations doing such an incredible job serving Indigenous Australians all around the country with the passion and professionalism and dedication they do is one thing. To get them all together, to form these partnerships, to build this trust, is another, and I want to thank you for our personal partnership that we've worked on so well for these many years now, and realising this day together and so many more ahead of us. Can I also welcome Fiona Cornforth, who's with us here today from the Healing Foundation. Met with Fiona some time ago as we first discussed the major announcement that we've made today regarding the Stolen Generation and the arrangements we've entered into there for the Northern Territory, the ACT, and right across those jurisdictions. A special shout out to those I know down there in Wreck Bay, which we're able to get a message to you today as well. And I know this is an important day for you and all of those who've worked so closely with your community over a long time. Of course, to the Minister for Indigenous Australians, who reminds me and all of my cabinet that we are all ministers for Indigenous Australians, and that's the way Ken works. Ken is a true inheritor, I think, and a carrier of the legacy of those who've gone before him in this place, particularly Senator Bonner. And he has carried this forward in a way that only Ken could. The opportunity to appoint Ken into this role and the way he has conducted himself in this role has been healing. It's been practical. It's been engaging. It's been wise, and his counsel we have all relied on through this process, his calm spirit and his wise counsel. So Ken, it's wonderful to be here with you also today. Today, in the Closing the Gap implementation plan, which I tabled in the Parliament, it reflects an important partnership. It reflects the fact that these goals that we have set now for many years, that we've provided greater detail to, have required and need a different way of delivering. It needed a different way of working together. That is not a criticism of previous efforts. All of these efforts have been well-intentioned. All of these efforts have been well-motivated. But good government and the delivery of important services is achieved by ensuring that you get your processes right, your partnerships right, you get your structures right, you get your systems right, so you can deliver on the ground. Because at the end of the day, the only thing that matters when it comes to closing the gap is closing the gap. And that only happens when more than 50 Indigenous organisations are empowered and supported to go and do the work they're doing, delivering services around this country. It only happens when state governments are doing what they need to do, when federal governments are doing what we need to do, and local governments are doing what they need to do. And that's what this new partnership is about. There's accountability. There's transparency. I can tell you, as Pat will agree, there's candid discussion. There's real discussion. But that has been made possible because of the trust that we have worked hard to build, that we can have the hard conversations. And there will always be, even with the commitments of more than $1 billion today, the single largest response that our government has made to the Closing the Gap commitments, there will still be the scrutiny. I have no doubt that through the joint council that Pat and Ken chair together, that work, that scrutiny, that pressure will continue to come, as indeed it should, because that's how good systems work. That's how good partnerships work. So I'm pleased we're able to act further today across a whole range of areas, whether it's in health, whether it's in justice, whether it's in education, which it's giving young people that hope, because at the end of the day, as I said in my speech today, when a young Indigenous boy or girl can grow up with the same expectations of any other Australian, not until that day is the gap closed. Not until that day. So I want to thank those who've co-laboured with us on this and will co-labour with us into the future. I'll pass you on to Ken, and then Pat, and then Fiona. Thanks, Ken.
Thank you very much, Prime Minister. And I also want to acknowledge my partner in the work that we've done together, Pat Turner, and Fiona in terms of the work we've done in respect of the Healing Foundation. What makes this extremely unique is that every word and every paragraph has been jointly negotiated and agreed to by the 51 peak organisations, our government, every state and territory government, including ministers, officials, and then the sign-off by National Cabinet endorsing the approach and endorsing the 17 targets that are in there that we will all work collectively to report on and to make achievements in gains against each of those targets. It's always been the Commonwealth that has reported in the past in the using aggregated data. This time, what we've done is state and territory parliaments will now report on these targets within their parliaments, within their jurisdictions. Substantial difference. Pat's work with her 51 peaks and the state and territory peak organisations will play a critical role in the partnership that has evolved from the work that we have done. The first meeting Pat was at in Redfern, she took a leadership role, and in that leadership role brought together 51 different organisations to work side by side, focusing on that the outcomes would be not about our organisations or our governments, but for the children of the future, for our communities, and for those who have been affected by government policies over a period of time. This is unique. It's an arrangement that I've not seen prevail at any other tier of government or any other government in the past, because we now all take joint accountability for this strategy, and it's a significant journey forward. The level of resourcing that our government has committed are in key and critical areas that focus on health, some of the infrastructure that is required for clinics, but more importantly, in the early years and the foundation years of a child's journey through both health and education. And then the other most significant plank is the partnership and joint accountability to each other. I have been buoyed by the responses of state and territory ministers in this whole process. I also want to acknowledge every cabinet minister in the Morrison government who have played a critical role in their own portfolios in committing to the directions that we have negotiated and co-designed with Aboriginal leaders, Aboriginal organisations, and them through the communities that they engage with. This now is owned by all of us. As a nation, this is a game-changing outcome, and the accountability and transparency will be a significant factor. But I want to congratulate everybody who's been involved, and the Prime Minister, I want to acknowledge your support, because leadership is absolutely critical in giving us the scope and latitude to explore what it is that we need to consider in achieving closure of many of the gaps. Some have become major areas that we need to do substantially more work in. I'll now hand over to my good colleague and friend, Pat.
Oh dear. Sorry about that. Thank you very much, Minister Wyatt. Today is another historic day under the partnership arrangement that was set up in December 2018 between the Coalition of Peaks and all governments on closing the gap. I want to acknowledge the leadership of the Prime Minister. It was you who first agreed to the proposal from the community-controlled leaders for a formal partnership with governments on closing the gap. It was also you who supported the national agreement being built around the four priority reforms that came from Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander peoples and the Coalition of Peaks, and are designed to change the way governments work with our organisations and our communities. Today, the Commonwealth is taking a significant step forward in making commitments a reality. I also want to thank Minister Wyatt, my co-chair of the Joint Council on Closing the Gap. The way in which we are working together is a testament to the partnership we have set out to achieve. Importantly, I also want to acknowledge the Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander community-controlled leadership around the country and those that make up the Coalition of Peaks. We came together to change the way governments are working with our organisations, our communities, and all Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander peoples. It has been a hard slog, but we are starting to see what can be achieved when we work together for all Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander peoples and when we partner with governments. The Coalition of PIGS also released its implementation plan today. You can find it on our website. We know that having a seat at the table with governments comes with significant responsibilities and obligations to our organisations, to our members and communities that we serve across Australia. Our implementation plan sets out our commitments to Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander people and to governments as part of our partnership. Like governments, we will report on our work annually. Today's funding commitments by the Prime Minister are very significant. Our people have waited a long time for compensation for stolen generation survivors. Fiona will speak with you in more detail about that, and the Healing Foundation is a part of the Coalition of PEGs. But I just want to say how much this means to me personally. It is important recognition. I also know, however, that there are many survivors that have died waiting for this recognition, my mum being one of them. The government is also making some significant commitments in the areas of early childhood, providing much needed additional supports and services, including in our remote communities. I am pleased to see that funding will be spent in line with priority reform too and delivered through our own organisations. I am very pleased that there is commitment to address the poor state of infrastructure in our community-controlled health clinics across the country. $100 million over the next few years to help us get those up to scratch. We've got a long way to go, but it's a very important commitment to which I'm very grateful to Greg Hunt. We also have some very important commitments to funding justice initiatives for our people and support for the Justice Policy Partnership, which we know you would know that we established after Joint Council in April this year. We have a long way to go to seeing improvements in the lives of our people across the country and for the gap of life outcomes to be closed. But this is an important step forward. The Coalition of PEGs will be working with governments over the next 10 years to make sure that we do all we can for our peoples and ensure the full implementation of the national agreement. Thank you.
Thank you, Pat. And Fiona?
I just want to say something about the compensation plan.
The Healing Foundation welcomes today's federal government announcement of reparations and wellbeing support for stolen generation survivors. We know how long and how tirelessly our community leaders have been working towards this, and it's an emotional time knowing that they've been heard and that our Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander community controlled organisations that have done the heavy lifting so long alongside impacted families have been heard. The scheme is practical support for stolen generation survivors to address the often complex health and economic needs that are evidenced to be a result of forced removal and forced removal alone. The truth of this is important. Reparations to acknowledge that truth is important. It's something, but it's not everything. It won't provide that end state of a healed nation, but there is hope in the priority reforms under the national agreement. I acknowledge Pat here as lead convener and all leaders of the coalition driving out better ways to achieve outcomes alongside governments. I echo Pat's thanks to the partnerships, to those involved. The reforms are critical, and we're grateful to be partners of an agreement and implementing an agreement that we contribute our excellence and our testimonies to collectively. Thank you.